Hey guys, it's time to answer a question that we've been getting a lot recently. It's time for a Q&A. Meow, meow, meow.
How do I figure out what I love to do if I don't feel like I have any specific interests? We get this question all the time, so let's dig into it. This is 4 ways to figure out what you love to do. Now, you've probably heard the advice that you should follow your passion or find the thing you love the most and then pursue it. The word passion comes with a lot of pressure. So instead of feeling like you need to decide on one thing that you love, we think it's more helpful to think about all the things that you like. No interest is too small or inconsequential. That sounds simple, but a lot of people have trouble figuring out what their interests even are. Let's get into it. Number one, stalk your history. Have you ever fallen down a Wikipedia rabbit hole where you get so caught up in learning about something, then you look up and realize hours have flown by? Maria Popova, founder of the blog Brain Pickings, told us we should pay attention to those rabbit holes.
The psychologist Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi has this term flow, the state of sort of being completely immersed in what you're doing so that you forget, you know, the passage of time, you forget that you're hungry, that you're thirsty, you're just doing it. And I found more and more the things that I was writing about and reading about for Brain Pickings, I was always in that state. I was just so sort of into it. I think once you find something that really, really gives you that sense of flow, that state of complete immersion and intense focus and interest, it is not so easy to let it go. You don't want to let it go. So you do everything possible to make it a centerpiece of your life.
Try to remember the last time you got into a flow. What were you watching or reading about? If you can't remember, stalk your history.
You do that? Take a look at your history?
I guess. Let's see. I've got roller skating. That's a new obsession. Biking, going outdoors, nature. Oh, social justice posts. Cooking. I'm trying to cook. I'm a really bad cook. See if there's a theme throughout, because that's where you'll uncover your interests. Number two, ask for help. Sometimes your friends and family can see what makes you happy, even when you don't see it yourself. For YouTuber Matt Best, he thought his consulting job was giving him purpose, but his friends knew otherwise.
I was doing a YouTube channel, kind of just a joke. I was just like, this is fun. I want to make my friends laugh. So once we started getting likes and viewership and following, like, this could be something. And it's a really scary moment because I ended up quitting a six-figure job, full benefits, when I had some friends say, hey man, you're not really happy in life. So I quit.
For Matt Best, taking his friends' advice paid off. So try it. Step outside yourself for a minute and ask for help. Ask your friends or family or teachers to describe you. Ask them what they think you like and what they think you're good at. Should I try that?
Yeah, do it. Call someone.
Okay, all right. This is gonna be weird, but.
Hey, Jenny, what's up?
Hey, Hannah, how's it going? So I'm just exploring my interests a little bit here and just want to know what you think I like. What do you think I'm good at?
Oh, you're so good at relating to people.
Aww.
You're so warm and always doing something exciting. So you're like rock climbing or you're swing dancing or you're community organizing in some way. You're so good at so many things.
Aw, thanks, Hannah. If you repeatedly hear you love helping people or you're great at solving problems, your peers are probably onto something because helping people is just as much of an interest as football or music. And it's a great foundation where you can start building a fulfilling career. Number three, get emotional. You might be searching for your interests in the places where you feel joy, but interests can also reveal themselves at times when you're especially angry or sad. Growing up, educator Lisa Nielsen thought school was boring and irrelevant. She didn't think it prepared anyone for the real world, and she hated that. Now, part of her job involves helping students figure out what they love to do, and she recommends they take the same approach.
So I think an important question for people to ask themselves as far as figuring out what they want to do in the world is what breaks your heart and what are you going to do about that? That's what it is that seeing that the work is really paying off by changing the things that piss me off in the world.
So what pisses you off? Work backwards and think about what really gets you heated up. Once you know what you hate, you can do some reverse engineering and figure out what you love. Plus, we've got a whole video about how you can support the causes you care about. We'll drop that link in the description. Number four, keep a journal. This exercise takes time, but we promise it'll pay off. Here's what to do. Grab a notebook and a pack of sticky notes and start journaling your heart out. Mark days or hours that felt especially fun or productive with one color of sticky note. Then use a different color to mark the days that felt especially long or dull. Soon you'll see the common threads running through the days you liked and disliked, revealing your interests as well as some equally valuable disinterests. Now what? Hopefully by the end of these exercises, you'll have nailed down your interests. And you're probably wondering, what should I do once I know what my interests are? Luckily, we have a much shorter answer for that. Go pursue them! If you've got questions for us on careers, life, whatever, leave them in the comments. And make sure to subscribe. We might answer your question in a future video.